How's it going, guys? My name is Matt. I'm my 98 Cobra. This is my car.
Take the Mustang Cobra. We're going to go and look at a couple of chargers. There's one at Maple Motors. There's one at a place called Niche Motors in Franklin. And then there's another charger that I've seen. It's at Alexander. I got to look that up, that place up, and see exactly where that's at. And these are dealerships here in Tennessee, kind of close to the Nashville area where I'm at. Maple Motors, I think, is in Hendersonville. And then there's Franklin. And then I think, I don't know where Alexander is. I got to look that up.
All right, let's get the GPS going and let's see where we're going today. So here we are at Jim Fikes Maple Motors in Hendersonville. And man, they have got some cool cars out here. Check out this dude. That guy, 60, I'm not sure, I hate to say it, 60 Impala, Firebird, just a bunch of cool cars. Just keeps good. Check out this truck. 12.9. Pretty cool. You see Tim, it says a 454 in it. 454. Thought this was my friend Paul's old truck, but it's not. But it just keeps going. I got some Mustang. So what I came for is sitting right there. All right, let's keep walking around and see what we got. Look at this dude. That's smooth. Is it a 68? It's a 68. Oh, I just sent this video over to my buddy Richard. He's been looking for a 68 for him and his son to work on. 8950. Take it home today. Look at that. Look at that. It was a 318 car. It's got a 383 in it now. It was a father-son restoration from what I can gather. There's a little plaque in the back. She's rough on the edges, but it's only 29.9. .383 with a Holley. I believe that's a four barrel. It's got headers on it. No power steering. It's got power brakes. Heater's hooked up. The doors don't work. He said that's one thing that he knows that doesn't work. Shade the side markers. It is a 69. I think this is like a base model. I don't know. I'm not that much of my knowledge of Mopars. Interior's not too bad. So we need that on there. Got the TikTok tack though. Automatic car. I think it's pretty nice. Flip up gas tank. It's got 255/45 ZR18s on the back. And 215/55 ZR17s on the front. Drum brakes all the way around. This is a 383 four barrel in the badge. But so a few things noticed and needed, but you know, hey, it's a 69 Charger. First thing you need is to be a radiator. Drivability. Doesn't have the blinkers aren't in. Got just some kind of film over them. So I'd like to get those hooked back up if it was mine. But this is charger number one we're looking at today. Paint feels great. 29.9. All right, I like it. It's rough. It's not exactly the condition I want. I like one that's, I mean, it's not in the worst condition that I have seen where it needs a bunch of work on it. This one's a pretty good candidate for a full restoration. Some of the work's already been done, I think. You know, probably the quarters have been prepared. I did open the trunk, and the trunk floor mat was slightly damp, so that needs to be remedied. But hey, this thing is it's definitely a driver. It's a good 20-footer driver. So let's go check out the other ones. So here we are at Niche Motors. Turns out the car wasn't on site, and then it was actually sold. So that's a big no-go. So the other one is the Alexander dealership. I'll get that one pulled up. But what I did see when I first pulled in was this guy right here. Check this out. This thing is gorgeous. It's a 04 F-150 Lightning. Absolutely beautiful. It is in such good shape. It says it's got 13,000 miles on it. Look how clear those lenses are. So clear. They got a lot of cool cars here. They got a lot of Porsches, and they got a GT3 RS, I think. But yeah, so I want to move on, try to find this Alexander shop, and we'll go from there. All right, so stopped by Starbucks, got some more go-go juice. Still haven't eaten lunch today. It's going on 4:30, and I had to stop and get some more batteries for the camera. Okay, so went to Gym Fights, got to see a 69 Charger that was a pretty good example. Need a little bit of work, missing a few things, but hey, you know, it's almost a 50-year-old car. It's 48. And so, you know, to be expected. I was also going to go look at Niche Motors. They had one on their website. Unfortunately, it was sold. It was auctioned off on eBay, and they actually never had the car there. It was a consignment sale. So, and it's being shipped out like next week. But either way, I couldn't look at it. It's a sold vehicle. So my last place I went to was Alexander Automotive in Franklin. And I'll put their description, web address in the description down below, as well as Gym Fights, Maple Motors, and Niche Motors. They had some really nice cars in Alexander Motors, but I didn't feel very welcome bringing the camera in, so I didn't get any footage of it. But at Alexander, the car wasn't there. It was in a warehouse. They are listing the price of the car of $235,000. And to view the car, you have to get an appointment, and which is understandable. I wouldn't want a lot of people around a car like that, that worth that kind of money, that can easily be damaged by, you know, careless people walking around or whatever. I mean, accidents do happen, but, you know, so to call that out, it's at the warehouse. You can go see it by appointment only. From what I understand, it's a really nice Charger. For $235,000, it better be. But it's kind of a rare. It's a 68 RT. It's got the 426 Hemi. It's a four-speed car, black with red interior with red bumblebee stripes on the back. I'm not sure if that's correct term for it. But yeah, so, you know, I was grateful at going to Maple Motors and seeing that 69 Charger. Was the highlight of the day. You know, if I had called the other places and they could have told me that it wasn't, that the cars weren't there, one, they were sold, or two, I'd have an appointment to go see it. And let's face it, they're not going to let too many tire kickers come in to go see a car. So, I had high hopes. But maybe one day I'll be able to afford something like that, and it would be great. You know, looking at cars, Chargers online, and seeing them in person, you know, when you're buying a car like that, you really should go see it in person before buying it. Unless, you know, have somebody you know that lives nearby where the car's for sale, go look at it, you know, call, you know, a shop nearby that they can take it to get it looked at. Have, you know, that way you have a second set of eyes on it. And, you know, definitely have the car put on a lift to, you know, see what the underbody looks like, get pictures of that if they don't already have pictures. You know, just have somebody look at it, and, you know, that has an unbiased opinion about it. That's what I've really gotten from this, you know, because I considered buying stuff offline, cars, but you really just can't tell by the pictures unless they're really good pictures. But I would definitely get a shop nearby, that person that they could take it to, and have them put it up on a lift and get a really good mechanics, you know, or unbiased thought on the vehicle. Guys, this concludes this episode. So I want to give a big thank you for sticking in there watching this video. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. And if you have any more ideas for upcoming episodes, just leave comments below, and we'll see what we can do with it. So thanks. Have a great day.